Hi, and welcome to another Max2Play tutorial. Today I will show you how to use the Max2Play plugin builder to create your own custom web interface tools with Max2Play. And to do this, I have a basic Max2Play setup. If you want to get Max2Play, just go on our website and download it for free, and you have an SD card image that you can put in your Raspberry Pi. And once you do this, you have this setup. Open your browser with Max2Play, and now you will have to install the plugin builder itself, and you can get it on our add-ons page. Just use the link that it's right on the settings page with a list of Max2Play extensions. You will be redirected to our extension page, and there you'll have the plugin builder right at the top. And to install the plugin builder, just click download, copy the link, and go back to your Max2Play web interface, enter the URL, and click install. This is also the way that other people can use your custom-made plugin for their Max2Play installation. And as you can see, it's installed, and right at the top you can just click on the plugin builder, and then you're ready to start to build your own custom plugin. The first thing you want to do is you can just create a new plugin, because right now you create plugins, there's nothing you can edit because you're not edited or you're not created any plugin yet. You click on the second tab and choose your name. And today we want to create a plugin that auto starts the browser on your Raspberry Pi desktop and opens a URL in full screen. So we call it Auto Start Browser. Click save, and yeah, that's all we got to do. Now we have already a new plugin that's called Auto Start Browser, and we find it also at the top of our navigation. Now what we have to do is we need to implement the the code that needs to be executed once we want to use our plugin. And therefore we can edit the controller file, edit a view file, or edit an install script or a custom script that needs to be executed once a button is pressed, for example. The first thing now we want to do is we just want to have a look at how it's looking, a new plugin with Max2Play. And we open a new tab, and there we see this is the example plugin that already contains some buttons and some input fields, a tab navigation or accordion navigation. So this example plugin just shows how the basic functionality works. And besides this obvious browser interaction, we can edit the files that are behind this. And with the plugin builder, we can click on Edit Controller File. When we do this the first time, the editor gets installed. A little confusing because there's a lot of message output while installing the editor. You can skip this, and you will find the basic editor of the example plugin that we installed at the bottom. You can see you can press F11 to get in full screen mode. I'll just do this, and here I have the controller file. It's in written in PHP language, and it contains the basic functionality of our example class. So at the top we have some basic construction of parameters and variables that we want to use, but we don't have to change a lot of the things to get our example with the auto start browser working. It's just for your information. You can do a lot of copy and paste things to get to where you want to. And for now, we just leave this. and go back to our plugin builder, have a look at the view file. The view file is the HTML logic, so it builds the page. You can see most of the parts of the file are contain the things that you just saw. As an example, I just change the top sentence of the page to this is our auto start plugin, and save it. And now, yeah, I just test it, and as you can see, it changes to this is our auto start plugin. So everything I want to edit with the plugin builder, I can easily do it within the browser. I don't need any other tools for this. Yeah. So, and the next thing we want to do is using the plugin builder to execute a script and yeah, install button to get our auto start browser working. So now we want to add the functionality to the install button to our auto start browser, and to do this, we have already the install functionality within the plugin builder. We can just edit the install script that gets executed once the install button is clicked. And here we have an example of an install script that gets executed. We just need to edit this script basically. I already prepared an install script and I copy and paste it right here. All this is doing, I'll explain it. The first thing, it does an update of the sources, then it installs the IceWeasel browser just to make sure we have a browser that we can open in full screen mode, and then we get the xdo tool. It's used to do basic functions to interface with control the interface basically, and then we need to add an auto start to the MaxDisplay auto start, which is the script which we will edit in the next place. This script will actually open the browser. So now this is just for the installation to have all tools in place that we need. And the next thing is to edit the script itself that does the auto start of the browser. So the install script, we save it, and now we go back to the plugin builder and we edit our script file that should get executed in the beginning when MaxDisplay starts. So in this case, we already prepared another script that we go through now. Yeah. So now this script just looks if there's already an IceWeasel instance running. If there is already one instance running, it just exits. And if not, we want to start our browser. We make sure IceWeasel is running and opening a URL. In this case, we just open the MaxDisplay URL. Then we put in a sleep into the script to make sure the browser gets opened within 10 seconds. That should be done. And after this, we make sure that we open the Firefox or the IceWeasel browser in full screen by giving this parameter to the xdo tool. And then we try to put the mouse somewhere else so we don't see the mouse on our screen. Another thing, we want to disable the screensaver to make sure that our browser keeps being open. Yeah, that's it pretty much. Now we save our plugin file, and and what we do have now is the basic function of an installer and a script that gets executed once MaxDisplay starts. To do the installation, we can go back to our auto start browser. Now let's have a look what happens when we click the install button. The install button is right here, called complex installer with Ajax or Ajax, and yeah, we just click it and then we'll see the output at the top. And what it does is what we installed, what we put into the install script. So we see how it's updating the sources for the Raspbian distribution. And yeah, once it's done, as we can see, it starts installing the browser package if it's not installed yet. Yeah, once this is done, we already added the functionality to the install script that it gets executed automatically. What we can't see now is how it actually behaves, how the browser is starting, and I will use a VNC client to get access to the desktop of the Pi to show you exactly how it is working. Okay, so meanwhile I installed the VNC server on the Raspberry Pi, and now I can access the desktop of the Raspberry Pi just with a, for example, with tight VNC, and just connect to the Max Display device. And there we go. Now we see the desktop because the browser already started, but what I want to show you is once we restart what happens. So now we go back to our web interface, to the settings page, and we just reboot Max to Play. So now the connection to the VNC gets closed. And we just wait till Max2Play starts up again, and then we open the connection. So maybe it's already running. No, it's not. Okay, I forgot to open the VNC server editor auto start. Okay. Okay, too late. The browser already started. What we can do is we can simulate a start. We can just close the browser on the device, and we just wait for the script to start. Now the desktop is a little bigger than my video frame, so the script of the cron job runs every minute, and here we see what happens. It automatically starts the browser, and now after 10 seconds it should go to full screen mode, as it does. So this is what our auto start browser plugin does. It opens the desktop in a full screen mode, and yeah, this is what our plugin does so far. If you want to beside the install button and yeah, beside the script, we want to make it a little nicer looking, we can edit the view file, for example, and remove everything that we do not need. In this case, we might remove all outputs of things that we don't want to share with anyone. Yeah, we can remove the first part, and we might remove the tab navigation, but we want to keep the install button, and the install button is right here, the installer. We just rename it installer, maybe remove the path, we don't need any path, and yeah, we can remove all this, and maybe also this. remove the tab navigation, remove the accordion. So yeah, we might remove almost everything besides our install button. Maybe we keep the debug information at the bottom to, yeah, for later to print something for debug. And yeah, once we save this, we just deleted a lot of things we don't really need. We can open the page again, and what we now have is just the installer with the install button. Yeah, if we want to share this plugin with others so that they just get the functionality to install an auto-start browser, we go to the plugin builder and we can download the plugin we created. By this, or by clicking this, we get a tar file that contains all what is needed to install the plugin on another Max to Play installation. Oh yeah, we can download this, save it, and everyone else is now able to just use this file, getting on the settings page, and you can install it from a local file or you can host it somewhere on GitHub, or if it's a really good plugin, everyone needs it, we can host it on our Max to Play website also. And anyone can just go install from a local file. To show you what happens, we go maybe to the plugin builder and delete the file that we just created to make sure it's not there anymore. And then you see we have deleted this add-on. We go on our settings page, install from a local file, and we choose the plugin that we exported recently. And there it is. And now we installed our plugin from our local repository or from our downloads, and then we see, okay, it gets automatically at the top, and so everyone can use your plugin by just installing it on the settings page. It's really simple. Everyone can use it, and yeah, you just need your browser to use the plugin builder to create plugins, to share your plugins with others. Have fun!